Dear colleagues, dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this conference of our Erasmus Plus program on cultural heritage as economic value, economic benefits, social opportunities and challenges of cultural heritage for sustainable development. We are very pleased by your participation and we hope that we have put together a challenging program that will generate discussion and will facilitate an exchange of views that will reward your time and effort to attend this conference. This is an inaugural event moving ahead, and we are pleased that this first public event has generated great interest on the much debatable concept of economic value of cultural heritage. My introductory remarks will try to answer three short questions. First, why is the economic and social value of cultural heritage important? Second, what is inherent? And third, what are the objectives and the content of this conference? Let me start first with the first question, why is the economic and social value of cultural heritage important? We start from Europe 2020, which is the European strategy and calls for a smart, sustainable and inclusive growth for Europe. This is the objective of the Europe 2020 strategy. Smart, sustainable and inclusive growth. Culture, in general, and heritage in particular, constitutes the fourth pillar of this strategy. At the same time, investing on entrepreneurial training is a clear strategic objective, and on that ground, creativity and innovative thinking have been defined as the necessary step-by-step prerequisite for fostering social, economic, and environmental sustainability. Similarly, many international organizations like the World Bank, UNESCO and the OECD consider cultural heritage as an important capital resource that can contribute to national, regional and local economic development. In that sense, cultural heritage represents a dynamic development potential where, according to research results, investment generates income more than 3.5 times the amount spent. And for addressing this dynamic potential as a developing resource, at local, regional level in the context of European crisis, two important factors should be emphasized. Culture and heritage is still a dormant capital. And many of the areas which suffer unemployment possess an impressive stock of cultural heritage. Now let me say a few words about the inheritance. This is a dissemination event of our INHERIT project. The INHERIT project is a three-year Erasmus Plus program aiming to raise awareness about the economic value of architectural heritage and its crucial role in creating local and regional development, contributing thus to building a smart, sustainable and inclusive economy in Europe with high levels of employment, productivity and social cohesion. The program's specific objectives are to increase public awareness for sustainable development, for the sustainable development potential of cultural heritage, and establish social initiatives that would build entrepreneurial partnerships investing on local and regional cultural heritage. We will use the following means in doing that: creating a platform as an interactive tool for information and communication, evaluating, assessing relative international good practices, and this is one of the reasons for the organization of this conference, and developing material that will be used for training individuals in cultural heritage in general and related social entrepreneurship in particular. The program output is expected to benefit the organizers, of course, and the participating organizations, individuals at local regional level as the final beneficiaries of the project, the entire local and regional societies, and the authorities responsible for planning development at the country or regional level. Finally, a few words about this conference. In this conference, we have put together a program with distinguished experts from a wide representative array of European and local institutions who are gathered to discuss on the economic value, governance and financing cultural heritage. We expect that the discussions and exchange will generate a discussion and exchange on various dimensions of the increasingly complex relationship between cultural heritage and economics. And the focus of the conference will be on the economic value of cultural heritage and how the two are related. Three broad issues will be discussed: the economic value of cultural heritage, management and governance of cultural heritage, investment needs and financing tools. Opening this agenda is clearly a challenging task, which may eventually be broken down to answering the following key questions. How do we balance need for conservation and preservation of heritage with the desire for development and change? In answering this question, we need to develop a dynamic new set of definitions, principles, and tools. And the second, how this expertise will be embedded in social engagement and consensus that would also help to define the social value of cultural heritage. We need this consensus, and this consensus is necessary to be built upon an understanding of all stakeholders. This is indeed an even more difficult endeavor, asking for a direct involvement of stakeholders and sectors. The output of this conference will be a volume that will comprise the presentations and discussions in the form of a companion reader, and this will be available for teaching and for training purposes of all stakeholders. Finally, we would like to wish to thank our sponsors and supporters. This is an Erasmus Plus program, and without its support, this conference would not have been materialized. We would like also to thank PPC, Aluminium Greece, and MedSec for their support. Our venue sponsor, Excelixi, for providing this excellent facility for our conference, which is the Center for Sustainable Entrepreneurship of the Bank of Rail Group, and the graphic designer sponsoring Press and Communication. Thank you all for your participation, and I hope that we will have a very fruitful conference.